Hi, I'm Marc Rothenberg, the senior author on our paper in the JCI Insights entitled Whole Exome Sequencing and covers oxioreductase, DHTKD1 and OGDHL1 as linkers between the mitochondrial dysfunction and eosinophilic esophagitis. I'm pleased to share with you the data that we uncover in our paper. My laboratory is focused on eosinophilic esophagitis, an emerging allergic inflammatory disease involving the accumulation and activation of eosinophils in the esophagus. The disease has a variety of symptoms, as shown in the slide. It varies with age, starting off with difficulties of growing, vomiting, abdominal pain, transitioning into difficulties swallowing, and eventually food impactions, which is shown on this slide. A piece of chicken lodged into the esophagus, presenting as emergency to the hospital with this food impaction, needing to undergo an urgent endoscopy to remove it. One can see in this slide the findings upon endoscopic biopsy, which is shown on the left, very active inflammatory state with large levels of eosinophils in an organ that normally doesn't have a single eosinophil. On the right, one can see this disease actually is reversible. It responds to elimination of specific food antigens that are driving the disease. It does reverse, but it actually will relapse upon adding the food back to the diet, so it's a dynamic process. There are other treatments, including glucocorticoids, as well as proton pump inhibitors, and one can see a complete reversibility of the histology. The disease, however, is chronic. It will universally relapse, so we need to understand more about treating it. We now understand the basic pathophysiology of the disease, as shown in the next slide, which involves specific susceptibility elements in the genome, genetic variants, particularly focused in this particular slide on a major variant in the calpain 14 locus on chromosome 2p23. This variant encodes for an intracellular cysteine protease that's specifically expressed in esophageal epithelium. It leads to a barrier impairment, as well as upregulation of particular cytokine responses, particularly TSLP. TSLP is also made by the esophageal epithelium, and that triggers the dendritic cell to polarize the type 2 CD4 cell into making large amounts of IL-13. It's very interesting to see that the IL-13 further induces the calpain 14, so one can see a loop, a cascade in this cycle, and the IL-13 also directly degrades the barrier through reduction of desmoglein. The disease has been elucidated genetically, primarily through genome-wide association studies. These studies have identified causal pathways, but not causal variants in the disease. A recent approach that has been now appreciated is to use whole exome sequencing to directly sequence the coding regions of the genome in an effort to identify causal variants. This is the approach taken in the current paper, which focuses in on the new findings that a series of genes in the mitochondria, particularly DHTKD1, as well as its homolog OGDHL, are causal in at least some of the patients, and evidence is presented a linkage between EoE and the mitochondrial pathway. I refer you to the paper directly to see the data, and I'd be happy to answer any questions. Feel free to reach out to me with them. Thank you very much, and I hope that you enjoy reading the paper.